expectation. The expectation basically that they are not basically progressing as fast as they believe they would, or the desire basically to acquire some sort of power, some sort of siddhis. And I have seen basically this kind of mistake not only in the people who are in the beginning stage of meditation, even basically even the meditation teachers, I mean the teachers who are teaching meditation. See, you have to understand one thing. The highest stage in the practice of meditation is, I mean, which is called Nibbana, is absolutely free from craving, free from desire, free from all expectations. So for example, if you are here, center, and Nibbana is on one side, totally freedom from suffering, freedom from craving, freedom from desire, and you started basically craving, you start desiring, you start expecting, so actually you start running in the opposite direction. See, when we crave something and we don't achieve it, so what happens? Frustration happens. So meditation basically is a kind of practice which is to change the mindset pattern, the pattern of our mind. It is to change that. So for example, in a corporate setup or in a working environment, most of the works are task oriented. So you are basically given a task, you have given a deadline, and you have to achieve it during a certain time period. And that's basically how you have been pressurized. But in meditation is exactly opposite. We are not basically fixing any task. Because the moment you start fixing task, you started desiring it, you start craving it. And the craving basically is opposite direction to the Nibbana stage, the final enlightenment stage. Now, it does not mean that you should not ask any question basically that if you are going in the right directions or not. No, you should learn it properly, the technique, meditation technique. And absolutely, if you don't understand anything, you definitely have a right, or you do feel it makes sense to go to your teacher and ask them basically any query which you have. But when you sit for meditation, you have to remember that craving, expectation, desire, egos, I mean, all these aspects should not be there, otherwise you're running in an opposite direction. Next video, I'm going to make how do you know that you are moving in the right direction when you're practicing meditation. If you think that you have enjoyed this video, or if you think that video was quite informative, feel free to like it or subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much for watching it. And if you have any query, feel free to write it in the comment section. I will be happy to answer it. Thanks.